In today's video, I'm excited to review some extraordinary shoes from one of the most well-known Italian shoemakers, Stefano Bemer.
I'm Kirby Allison, and I love helping the well-dressed acquire and care for their wardrobes. Join me as we explore the world of quality, craftsmanship, and tradition.
As all of you know, we've reviewed a lot of British shoemakers here on Kirby Allison, but today I'm excited to review our first maker from Italy, Stefano Bemer. Based in Florence, Stefano Bemer is perhaps one of the best known Italian shoemakers and a real influence in the shoemaking industry. In addition to making incredible bespoke shoes and ready-to-wear shoes, Stefano Bemer is also very well known as having one of the few formal shoemaking schools in the world. He's trained many of today's finest bespoke shoemakers. Stefano Bemer started repairing shoes in 1983 when his local town cobbler passed away. After a local aristocrat invited Stefano to view his collection of bespoke John Lobb shoes, Stefano was inspired to move to Florence to take up bespoke shoemaking under a local master. Stefano's work was quickly recognized for pairing exceptional craftsmanship with creative Italian designs and for not compromising any parts of the bespoke shoemaking process. In 2012, Stefano tragically passed away at a very young age. He was only 48 years old. The company was purchased by Tommaso Milani, who continues to run it to this day and developed the firm's ready-to-wear and made-to-order collections of shoes. In addition to their superb bespoke shoes, Stefano Bemer is probably best known as one of just a handful of firms out there with a ready-to-wear collection of shoes that are completely handmade with hand welting. These shoes are made using the exact same materials, craftsmanship, and techniques of a bespoke shoe, but on a standardized ready-to-wear last. The firm essentially has three ranges of ready-to-wear and made-to-order shoes and two levels of their bespoke offering. Each range pays close attention to the anatomy of the foot, which was considered whenever they were developing the lasts, and features a high arch support and a tight heel cup, which ensures that the shoes fit snugly and are comfortable to wear. Most interestingly, though, is that Stefano Bemer's shoes feature a slightly sturdier, heavier construction than comparable Italian shoes that was necessary in order for the shoes to stand up to the cobblestone streets that you find in Florence. This is a really nice, quite unique characteristic of Stefano Bemer's shoes that really sets them apart from what you would traditionally find in an Italian shoe. Stefano Bemer has essentially three ranges of their ready-to-wear and made-to-order shoes. First is the Essenziale, or the Essential Collection, which is available and ready-to-wear only and is represented by 10 different models that really serve as that foundation to any shoe collection. These are machine-made, machine-welted shoes and have machine outstitching, but still uses a lot of the same quality of materials that what you find in the higher-end ranges. Stefano Bemer actually worked with Simon Crompton of Permanent Style to design this collection of shoes. Next, we have the Classica range, which is available in both ready-to-wear and made-to-order and features a hand-sewn welt. The outsole, though, is still sewn on by machine. And lastly, we have the Tradizione line, which is Stefano Bemer's highest range collection of ready-to-wear and made-to-order shoes. This is really, for all intents and purposes, a made-to-order shoe and features the highest level of handwork that Stefano Bemer offers, except with a ready-to-wear or standard last. This shoe is fully handmade, and I'll get into the details of how this shoe is made in a little bit. But first, let's talk about the Essenziale collection. The idea of the Essenziale came from Simon Crompton. The concept is a collection of ready-to-wear shoes in 10 styles that every man should have in his closet. That's why it's called the Essenziale, or Essential. The shoes start at 850 euros, which is about $1,000. They come with their own wooden shoebox and individual shoe bags, and this is really a factory-made Goodyear welted shoe where the outsole is sewn on with the machine, but really features all of the elements of quality and craftsmanship that you would expect from a fine shoe. The leathers are all full-grain, open-pore leather, absolutely beautiful. The outsole is sewn together with a high stitch density. It features nice support, and really just has great finishing that you would expect at this price level. Now, with all of Stefano Bemer's shoes, there's a slight fashion-forwardness to the way that he designs his models that really reflects their Italian heritage. The shoe features a nice narrow waist and features an invisible channel stitching, a nice 100% leather heel stack that sits very neatly and tightly underneath the heel cup. And this is an exceptionally crafted, beautiful shoe that lives up to Italian standards. Next up is the Classica line, which is Stefano Bemer's famous ready-to-wear line. The thought behind this collection is to still offer clients who do not need bespoke a shoe with as much bespoke elements built into it as possible. All of the uppers of the Classica shoes are hand-clicked, which means that they're cut out by hand, allowing the person doing the work to position the pattern pieces to only use the best unblemished pieces of the hide. The welt is sewn onto the insole by hand, which is again what we call a hand welted shoe. So this, instead of being Goodyear welted with a ribbing that goes inside the shoe, this is done by hand, and it's the same way that a bespoke shoe would be made. But instead of sewing on the outsole to the welt by hand, the outsole on the Classica range is sewn on with a machine. This is available in both ready-to-wear and made-to-order shoes. The Classica shoes are available for 1,150 euros, or about $1,300. And for an extra 100 euros, you can have any pair made to order. This model I have here is a beautiful example of a single monk with a shark skin strap. It's available made to order, so this would be about $1,500 from Stefano Bemer. This is an absolutely beautiful shoe that really showcases Stefano Bemer's beautiful elegance and balance that he has to his last. It's an absolutely beautiful example of a single monk, and I really appreciate how the sharkskin strap adds a bit of really subtle adventure to this shoe. You can see that it's superbly made, again, with beautiful finishing on the outsole, invisible channel stitching, a nice, beautiful heel base that, of course, is made out of 100% leather stacks. It sits neatly underneath the heel cup. You can see the heel cup has nice shape. There's beautiful arch support, and there's structure to this shoe with hard stiffeners that, again, is going to ensure that this shoe is comfortable because it's giving your foot proper support. It's really, by all means, a bespoke shoe only made on a standard last and with the outsole being sewn on with the machine. And lastly, the third collection that we have is the Tradizione line. The Tradizione line is made to the exact same standards of a bespoke shoe. It has hand-sewn shanks, creating a nice beveled or fiddle-backed waist, really whatever the client wants. And it is by all means as close to a bespoke shoe as possible, except it's being made on a standard last. The fiddleback is made by preparing the shank in a V-shape and really gives just a beautiful finish to the bottom of the shoe that you really only find at the highest end of bespoke shoes. Whenever I turn over a shoe, I could really tell the quality and attention to detail of a shoemaker. The outsole features, of course, an invisible channel stitching. As I said, this shoe has a completely hand-sewn welt. That's where the welt is sewn on completely by hand, again, giving greater durability and flexibility to the shoe, and also decreasing the amount of space that you have in between the insole and the outsole, which makes a shoe that is much more comfortable. This Tradizione shoe is superbly made, and whenever you look at the bottom of the shoe, you can really appreciate the attention to detail of Stefano Bemer whenever it comes to this collection. As I said, the shoe is completely hand-lasted. Now, what does that mean? That means that after the upper is hand-clicked, cut out by hand, ensuring that only the best pieces of leather are used, it is then sewn together using a high stitch density and then fully lasted by hand. This is the process where the upper is pulled over the insole and nailed to the last. Now it is left to sit on the last for several days or a week, which allows, again, the uppers to take the full shape of the last itself. Now this is very important because the way that the shoe is lasted is what gives definition and shape to the shoe itself. And you can see that this shoe has a very high arch support and a beautifully shaped heel that's going to ensure that this shoe fits beautifully. Now, after the shoe is lasted, you can see where a channel is cut into the insole. That's done before it is nailed to the bottom of the last. And then what you have is the hand welting. Now, the hand welting is the traditional method where the welt is attached to the uppers and the insole. And so what you have is a piece of a twine that is strung together and sewn by hand. This goes through every single layer of the shoe and really forms the spine of the shoe, holding it all together. So what you see, this welting is going through the insole, the interlining, any hard countering, the upper, and the welt, and holds all those pieces together. Now at this point, the nails are removed because no longer do you need those nails holding all those pieces together. That's the function of the hand-sewn welt. After the welt is sewn, you have the interior finishing. So this is where leather is packed into the inside of the shoe to fill this channel or void that's left from the welting. So this fills the shoe, it provides cushion, it allows the shoe to really mold to the shape of your foot. And then here you see Stefano Bemer beginning to develop this really beautiful, highly sculpted fiddleback waist that is done here across the shank. Now this gives that beautiful shape that you see here once the shoe is finished. The amount of work that's going into the bottoms of these shoes really surpasses the amount of work that goes into some factory-made shoes in their entirety. So after this is done, then you see the next step where the outsole is sewn on by hand. Now this, again, is the difference between the Classica and the Tradizione. On the Classica, the outsole would be sewn to the welt by machine in the same way a factory-made Goodyear welted shoe would be done. But on the Tradizione, they take it one step further, closer to bespoke, by sewing on the outsole to the welt completely by hand using a technique called invisible channel stitching. Now that technique is where they slice into the outsole, peel it back to allow this sewing to be done in a way that after it's finished completely conceals the outsole stitching. Now that's one of the hallmarks of a really high quality made shoe that I absolutely love. It's not unique to bespoke. You can find it on really high end ready to wear shoes. We do it in our Kirby Allison certified shoe restoration program. But again, it's one of those hallmarks and details that you expect on a shoe at this quality point. And whenever it's finished, the result is really superb. You end up with a beautiful shoe that's incredibly well lasted, has great last definition, and then you turn it over and you just see an absolutely beautiful outsole that is meticulously finished. And it's those details that I really love about high quality shoes. Now, kind of extending around again, you see all the elements of quality and craftsmanship that you would expect from a shoe at this level. You have a beautiful heel stack that is shaped with glass. It pitches in slightly. It sits very neatly and tightly on top of the heel and just produces a beautiful shape. Now, again, this shoe features extensive hard countering, which are those hard pieces of leather inserted into the areas of the shoe that don't flex in order to give the foot support. So the Tradizione is priced at 1,650 euros, which is right around $1,800 or $1,900. And although they have a small collection of these in a ready-to-wear line, really at this price point, this is a made-to-order shoe. Now what's beautiful about the made-to-order process is you can have them make anything, and so you're only limited by your imagination. And also Stefano Bemer is able to incorporate small last modifications. Like if you're like me and have a high instep, they're able to build this up to help the shoe be even more comfortable. This comes in their wooden box and fully lasted shoe trees. Now what I'm holding right here is a particularly special example of their Tradizione shoe. And this is made from their replica 1786 Russian reindeer leather. This was tanned in collaboration with Chicago tannery Horween and is made using the same techniques of the traditional Russian reindeer leather that is so famous within the shoemaking industry. Now, those that aren't familiar with the story of the Russian reindeer, there was a merchant ship that was sailing from Russia to the United Kingdom in 1786 with a load of Russian reindeer leather, and it sank right off the coast of Cornwall. Now, in the 1980s, a group of divers discovered this ship and began salvaging some of these hides from the shipwreck itself that some English bespoke shoemakers used to make their shoes. I actually have a pair of Russian reindeer shoes made bespoke by George Cleverly in a split-toed derby that is absolutely lovely. Now, the leather is very rare and difficult to come by, really only available through a few bespoke makers. But now we have a few tanneries that have actually resurrected this traditional way of tanning their leather, and you can find it here with this shoe. Now, Simon Crompton actually has this exact same shoe made for him, and it's a cap-toe semi-brogue made with that 1786 Russian reindeer. And finally, Stefano Bemer has their bespoke range, which is divided into two levels. You have your blue bespoke, where the shoe is made up the same as a normal bespoke shoe, only that the outsole is stitched onto the welt by machine. That is the only difference. It still has a fully bespoke, customized last, and that retails for 2,650 euros. And then you have Sixpence, which is the top of the line bespoke range and is completely hand sewn with the outsole sewn on by hand and has all the bells and whistles of a bespoke shoe that you would expect. And that retails for $3,650. So in Stefano Bemer's Tradizione range for 1,650 euros, you end up with all of the elements of quality and craftsmanship, a totally handmade shoe with a hand-sewn welt, a hand-sewn shank, hand-sewn outsoles that you would find in their highest-end Sixpence range, except for 2,000 euros less. The only difference is that with their Sixpence range, you're getting that fully bespoke last. Stefano Bemer, who we lost too early at just the young age of 48 years old, was really a pioneer and a legend in the shoemaking industry and had a profound impact on the way that shoes are made today. He was the first person to add segmentation between a factory-made Goodyear welted shoe and bespoke by adding these levels in between that are still ready-to-wear or made-to-order shoes that aren't bespoke because they don't have that expensive bespoke last, but still incorporates many of the elements of quality and craftsmanship of a bespoke shoe, but in a ready-to-wear or made-to-order shoe that in some cases is several thousand euros less than what you would have to pay in a bespoke shoe. In particular, integrating that hand-sewn welt and the hand-sewn outsole into a ready-to-wear shoe was unheard of before Stefano Bemer introduced that. Stefano Bemer, in many ways, was instrumental in the resurgence of high-quality handmade footwear. And you have to take this all within the context of that during the 1980s and the 1990s, the shoemaking trade as a whole was experiencing a decline where you had the removal of a lot of elements of quality and craftsmanship moving towards a more mass-produced factory-made shoe. So Stefano Bemer to come in during the 80s and 90s and really introduce these high-end bespoke levels of craftsmanship into a ready-to-wear and made-to-order range was really quite revolutionary and groundbreaking. And one of the things that I hear whenever I speak to people about Stefano Bemer is how they really appreciated his steadfast commitment to quality and craftsmanship. At a time when a lot of shoemakers were beginning to outsource their manufacturing to Far East countries, Stefano Bemer never compromised or gave into that pressure and stood behind his shoes and his philosophy of only making the highest quality shoes using the best materials, finest craftsmanship, and highest quality possible. Stefano Bemer has a showroom in New York City where you can meet with them to have any of these shoes made. And of course, if you're traveling through Italy, especially if you're passing through Florence, Stefano Bemer's beautiful atelier is a place that absolutely must be visited for anyone that loves high quality footwear. These shoes are absolutely beautiful, and I can't tell you how appreciative I was of Tommaso to sending us these samples so that we could see them and review them for you here on Kirby Allison. I'm Kirby Allison, and I love to help the well-dressed acquire and care for their wardrobes while exploring the world of quality, craftsmanship, and tradition. If you haven't had a chance to visit kirbyallison.com, please do, where we have the largest collection of luxury garment care, luxury shoe care, and other fine clothing accessories anywhere in the world. I'm Kirby Allison, thanks for joining me. In today's video, I'm wearing a new jacket I just received from mytailor.com or Joe Him or Johnny. It's a beautiful odd jacket by Holland & Sherry in a light blue window pane. It has a little bit of gray worked into it, which allows me to pair it with gray slacks. Of course, I'm wearing one of our new Kirby Allison Sovereign Grade ties. This is a blue grenadine, which works perfectly with the slightly busier pattern of this odd jacket. And what I love about our Sovereign Grade ties is how well lined they are. As you can see, it ties an absolutely beautiful knot and has a great hand. I'm wearing one of my bespoke Charvet shirts. That is a beautiful blue striped shirt with the blue monogram. I'm also wearing a pair of dark gray high-waisted trousers from Joe Him or Johnny. They have single reverse pleats and tab trousers. And as you can see, they sit quite high on the waist. And a blue Simon Crompton pocket square. I'm wearing a pair of my Sovereign Grade black wool and silk socks. This is a solid sock that works great with this outfit. And my beautiful pair of bespoke George Cleverly burgundy alligator Baron Derini shoes.